So today we will talk about the NASA recent launch, LCRD, basically the Laser Communication Relay Demonstration, and what are its basic features and what is the main purpose of LCRD and the difference between the radio and the laser, and what are the more advantages of laser than the radio wavelength. So let's talk about. If you talk about on December 7th, if you talk about the NASA launched its new Laser Communication Relay Demonstration. So this is the mission has been launched by the NASA, remember that. If you talk about the LCRD, remember that NASA, it is the NASA first ever, remember that it is the NASA first ever communication system from the Cape Canaveral Space Force Station in Florida, USA. So remember that it is the first ever communication system which is related to the laser, optical, remember that it is not the first communication system but first laser communication system. Remember that if you talk about. The LCRD payload is hosted on board by the US Department of Defense Space Test Program satellites STP SAT-6. Remember that it can be asked in various examinations. So remember that. If you talk about, it will go into the geosynchronous orbit. Remember that there is a low earth orbit, medium orbit, and now the geosynchronous orbit, which is above the 35,000 kilometer from the earth, and where actually this LCRD is going on. So remember that. If you talk about, what is the main purpose, if you talk about what is the main job of the LCRD, then remember that it will help to test the optical or laser communication in the space. What happened earlier, all the communication system is based on the radio wavelength, which is the more transmissible and they can transfer the data in a rapid manner. But now they are sending the optical communication system in this way to test the efficacy of the laser communication system. So remember that. And it will also help to demonstrate all the advantages to use them operationally. Basically, to look at the effectiveness of the laser communication, are there any advantages than the radio, and how we can use the laser or optical communication during the space mission, and how we can transmit the data from the earth to the space and from the space to the earth. So this is the main job of the LCRD. Now we will talk about the difference between the laser and the radio wavelength. So if you talk about all the earlier missions of the NASA, actually they uses the radio frequencies. And if you talk about for the first time, they uses the laser or optical communication. Now what is the main benefits of the optical and the laser communication, if you talk about, than the radio? So if you talk about the advantages, so let's talk about. So here if you talk about the laser or optical communication system and the radio communication system, then there are some differences and you need to remember the differences, particularly from the point of view of exam if you talk about. Then remember that it will increase the bandwidth. Laser communication, if you talk about, it will increase the bandwidth from the 10 to 100 times than the radio. What is the main advantages of increment in the bandwidth? If you talk about it related to the data transfer, it speeded the data transfer. So suppose in the radio, if the data transmission is, suppose in the 10 times or it takes a 1 minute to download a movie from the, so if you talk about the laser and optical communication, it will take a one second to download a movie. So this is the main difference of bandwidth. If there is an increment in bandwidth, there will be a more speedier data transfer. Remember that. Further, if you talk about the laser and optical and the radio communication, then remember that it uses the infrared light and have a shorter wavelength. Now what is the main advantages of the shorter wavelength? So shorter wavelength is also related to the data transfer. So remember that if there is a shorter wavelength, then there is a speedier data transfer which will take place. And suppose if something which is going on from the earth to the Mars, then there is a in the radio frequency if you talk about, then it will take let's say 50 days to complete that the orbit if you talk about. Then if laser or the optical communication, then it will take let's say 5 days, 10 days. So it is the less. So this is the more advantages of the shorter wavelength if you talk about. Now if you further talk about, it will help to transmit data in the lesser time, as I have already told you, through the radio frequency if you talk about the laser or optical communication system. Then remember that there is a smaller in size, weight, and require less power in the laser or optical communication than the radio if you talk about. Obviously if there is a less size, then it will so there will be more instruments can come in the satellite if you talk about. And if you take the less weight, then it will be a less stress on the satellite if you talk about, and obviously there are these some batteries in the satellites, or if you talk about if something which is going on in the space. So there will be a less power if required in the optical or laser communication, then there will be a less stress on the batteries if you talk about. So this is the one of the main advantages if you talk about related to the laser or optical communication over the radio communication. So remember that. If you talk about, then with the optical communication, so obviously it is at the very nascent stage, as I have told you that this is the first ever satellite which is going on in the space if you talk about. Then remember that optical communication supplementing radio mission have a unparalleled communication capability. So in future there will be a combination of optical and radio, and it will be a more advantageous than the earlier alone radio frequency. So this is all about of the NASA LCRD mission. Thank you guys. Hope you like this video.